Hey there guys, today in this video, we're going to learn how to submit your GIC in CIBC Bank for your Canada study permit. So without wasting any more time, let's jump in. Alright, so the first thing that you have to do is type CIBC Student GIC, and then you're going to ignore these two advertisements at the top, and you're going to click on this link. I will also add it to the description. Now, once the next page loads up, you're going to click on Apply Now. On this page, you will select Student GIC Program, and here you're going to choose your country. I'm from India, so I will select that. Once the rest of the information loads up, you can see the total amount of money you will eventually have to deposit in your GIC account. You can click on this checkbox if you want to deposit the payment in Canadian dollars. If not, you will click on this button that says Select. Now, you'll have about 20 minutes to finish the rest of the form. To get to the next section, click on Student Information. Once the form loads up, you need to fill all your details. Make sure the details that you fill up are the same as the ones mentioned in your passport. You only have to fill the mandatory questions which are marked by an asterisk. You can leave out the ones that have optional written next to them. If your program of study is mentioned, then select it. Otherwise, you can choose Program Not Listed from the drop-down list. Student ID is optional, but it's good to fill it out anyway. Your tentative arrival date is mentioned in your letter of acceptance, so make sure you fill it according to that. It's a tentative date, so it doesn't have to be super accurate. The same thing goes for your graduation date as well. It is mentioned in your LOA. If you are paying in INR, it is important to send the funds from your own bank account. If you send it through someone else's account, even through your parents' account, your GIC request will be rejected. So make sure you use your own account to transfer the funds. I paid my GIC in Canadian dollars via SWIFT transfer. If you are doing the same, then make sure you enter your own details in the sender's form. Now, do not change anything else, leave it as it is. After this, click on Browse and attach your LOA. Now, type your address, province, which is basically your state, then your city, PIN code, phone number, and email address. Even if you haven't registered before, it's fine. Just type in your email address, confirm it, and then set your password. Make sure it follows all the given requirements. Next up, you need to enter your passport details. Your passport number, issue date, expiry date, country of citizenship, and your date of birth. Make sure they are accurate. Now comes the referral details section. CIBC has a very interesting referral program. If you decide to use someone else's referral email, you, as well as the person whose email you used, get a bonus of 25 Canadian dollars, which gets deposited in your GIC account. So it's a win-win situation for all. Under the How did you hear about us part, choose Friends and Family, leave the Details section blank, and click on Yes for Are you applying through the referral program? It is important to select this option if you want to receive the $25 bonus. Now for email address of the referrer, you can either choose the email of someone you know, or if you find this video helpful and want to help me out as well, you can use my email, which is thesiddharthkadyan@gmail.com. I will also add it in the video's description. Once you complete your GIC process, both of us will get a $25 bonus added to our accounts. After this, you need to select your remitting bank, account number, and your PAN number. Make sure you use your own details here. Now, select all the confirmations in the declaration section, double-check your details, and you're good to move to the next part. Finally, click on Payment Summary. Now, verify all the details. If you want, you can download all of these documents and give them a read. Lastly, check these two options and click on Submit. Once you do that, your application will be submitted to the CIBC team and they will send you an email regarding the acceptance of your application within 2 to 3 working days. Right after you submit your application, you would receive this email on the address you provided earlier. Once CIBC approves your application, you will receive another email with more information. After receiving the approval email, log into your CIBC account and download your payments instruction letter. It looks like this. Since I paid my GIC in Canadian dollars, all the details are related to that particular transfer. For INR or any other currency, your instruction letter will be slightly different. After you transfer your funds, you will receive an acknowledgement email and the status of your GIC application on your account will be changed to processed. By clicking on View Details, you will be able to download your GIC certificate by selecting and downloading Investment Advice Letter from the pop-up. Your GIC letter will look somewhat like this. You can also read the other documents associated with your account. They have detailed instructions on how to activate your student account once you reach Canada. Here is a breakup of all the payments that you will be getting on a monthly basis. Aside from this, you will also get a payment of $2,000 when you reach Canada and activate your account. The bonus money you get from referrals will also be added to your student account. That's all. If you have successfully completed all of these steps, then congratulations. Your GIC process is now complete, and you can move on to other important things. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments section below. You can also reach out to me on Instagram. My Instagram ID will now appear on the screen. Let me know in the comments if you found this video helpful, and also give it a like if you did. Feel free to share it with whoever is struggling with their GIC process. Thank you.